Today's Mailbag Monday pairs nicely with Living in Arabica Soulful Brown Ale from Devil May Care Brewing in Winnipeg. It is a coffee-infused brown ale with deep toffee and caramel notes. That's awesome. As you can see, we've got a fairly large pile of mail here. The largest being this huge box on the bottom, which was a gift from one of you guys. So I'll put that aside and get into these smaller packages here. Starting with expansion board module. Always a popular choice. Oh, a couple of little tiny ones here. And they didn't open very well. These are from Keys Studios. They are WiiChuck K-Duino. These are for the little connectors, for little breakout connectors for the Wii Nunchuck game controller thing. These kind of controllers here that I picked up from thrift stores cheap, for like a buck each. So these just plug in like that, then go into a breadboard, and you can use your Arduino or Arduino-like board to pull information off of. So we have a plus and minus voltage, data and a clock. So that implies that it is some sort of a serial communication protocol. So that's something to play with, and a fairly convenient little form factor to control, a robot or a robot arm or some other sort of thing. So there's a joystick with X, Y in it, which I think is analog. Two buttons up there. And if I'm not mistaken, there's some kind of an accelerometer in there. So it can tell this kind of movement. I'm not sure. We'll have to play with those at some time in the future once I do a little bit more research. I2C WiiChuck Nunchuck Adapter Shield Module Board for Arduino. I bought a two-piece package from Module Fans at auction. They don't seem to have a two-piece package right now. They've got this five-piece package. But I'm going to link you to a search, I think, that'll come up with a whole bunch of them. Because right now they're selling it for $285 and a stupid amount of shipping. But that aside, it's a breakout board for the Wii Nunchuck to achieve communication to the Nunchuck and another Arduino. Yeah, we already figured that out. It is great for DIY projects. Okay, next in we have LED light times two. Could be. Oh, some little bi-pin LEDs with a whole bunch of actual LED light chips on there. 6, 12, looks like 24 elements on there. Probably a little bridge rectifier and then a couple of resistors. Okay. So I'm going to guess that this is automotive, which means it'll want 12 volts. Well, that's fairly bright and warm white. Let's see if I was right that is a bridge rectifier. Yep. It is bisexual. It doesn't care which way it goes. One other thing to try is this old desk lamp of mine. It's just got a transformer in the base of it that puts out 12 volts. So it should just be an AC 12 volts. Let's see if this guy will work with that. Oh yeah, it does nicely. And it actually fits underneath where the glass goes, as opposed to the last little one of these that I got to try in there that's too big and doesn't fit. So that's a win there too. Now my old desk lamp works and I don't have to try and find little stupidly hot halogens to put in there. Nice. Oh yeah, the other thing, what's the current that this thing's taking? 65 milliamps. Okay, so that's negligible. This thing here claims to take a 20 watt max, so that's well under that.
2x3 watt G4 LED 24 SMD LED spotlight corn bulb Lampe DC 12 volt warm cool white. I got it from SPE Vert, who doesn't have anything on here. I paid 52 cents at auction with free shipping. But here is a random listing that has exactly those bulbs on it. And what they say about it is G4, which is the shape or size, AC-DC 12 volt, 2 watt LED lamp. Warm white, yeah, flexible silicone, yeah. The transparent part is in fact flexible squishy silicone. 10 millimeters by 35.4 millimeters. Yeah, that's about right. And the third thing from China, 1x screws. That doesn't sound all that exciting. Aha! It's not what it says on the package, though. Those clearly aren't screws. These are a bunch of fuses with leads on them. There was something that I was repairing back when I ordered these, and I didn't have any in stock other than one surplus fuse that I took out of something else. So I got 1, 2, 1.5, 2.5, and 0.5. Okay, now that you know that, that could easily be 0.5. Okay, and it looks like there is about 10 of each. That could come in handy for repairing stuff in the future. Kind of wish I had it back. Oh, I know. This was that clapper. Clap on, clap off, sound activated switch. Yeah, that's the one. It had a popped fuse in it, so I had to use something that had salvaged. Yeah, now I remember. Okay. 0.5 amp, 1 amp, 1.5 amp, 2 amp, 2.5 amp, 3 by 10 millimeter glass fuse, tube, axial lead, wire, fast blow fuse, 250 volts. This is a mixed kit of 50 pieces, 10 of each value. We already knew that. It cost me $3.26 from HKDZ-2019. I didn't pay any shipping on it, but like so many things from China these days, there is a shipping fee that is more than the product is worth. All right, that's it for the stuff that I ordered from China. Now I got a couple of things that you generous viewers sent me. This came from Adam in Springfield. I'm not going to tell you which Springfield. Got a little envelope and a couple of note cards. Okay, he says he's enjoyed my videos. Thanks, Adam. And he's just joined my Patreon. Thank you very much, Adam. Wow. He hopes he finds these useful. There's a little bit more information on here, which I'll pull out later, because that would spoil the surprise. It is an ST-Link STM32 programmer. It's a USB on that side, and we got here reset, clock, ground voltage, voltage, SWIM, and SWDIO. I know almost nothing about STM32 boards or their programming, although I did get a blue pill module. Yeah, this little guy here, which is an STM32 103, etc., etc., bunch of numbers. So apparently this is the way to go for programming these things rather than using the Arduino IDE, which was my initial inclination. Are those labeled? Are those pins labeled on the end there? Those are labeled ground, clock, I.O., and 3.3 volts. Okay, and those exist in here. So now I have even more reading to do and figuring out. And the big thing that's slowing me down on this right now is having a project and application that needs that much power. But I'm going to come up with something in a while here. I'm sure of it. If you have some suggestions down in the comments section, and let me know what you think I should do. Otherwise, I probably will eventually do just a tinkering with video to play with this STM32 stuff, because, like I said, I haven't touched it before. So the other note, the other part of the note, he said that he had some trouble programming STM32 boards like the blue pill until he got one of these things.
And he uses it with the Arduino IDE with the board definitions installed. And here is the connections to the STM32 Blue Pill board, which kind of matches what I was guessing there. It also says that STM32-base.org is a great resource for these boards. Thank you so much, Adam. That is going to knock a big chunk off my learning curve when I get to playing with those STM32 boards. And now, the big kahuna here. This came from Mark in Michigan. He emailed me and said it was coming. I said, okay, just beware of postage. He said, yeah, no problem. And then emailed me back a couple of days later and said, damn, you weren't kidding about the cost of postage to Canada. So let's see what he generously provided us to play with here. There is one clue on the customs declaration. Electronics scrap. I am intrigued already. That's the kind of random thing that I love to get. Oh, goody, packing peanuts. Okay, I'm going to pull stuff out of this box, get these packing peanuts out of the way, and I'll be right back. Okay, there was two quite heavy things in that box. I think I'll start with a small one. Well, no, I'll start with a bigger one first, just so that I've got room to play with the smaller one when I get to it. I didn't find any note in there. There's a couple of hints in his email to me, but again, I'm not gonna... Oh, wow, that looks industrial. Laser radiation. Do not stare into beam. Avoid exposure to laser. Wow. Made by Perceptron? What do you say in the back here? Use only Perceptron power cable, blah, blah, blah. Power input. Laser radiation. Class 2M laser product, average power 1 milliwatt, wavelength 635 to 690 nanometers. So, model is FlexiCam Pro, blah blah blah, made in October 2010. Interesting. FlexiCam. It's a laser and a camera? Whatever it is, it's chunky heavy. There's a little cover that pops off there, though. Got some mounting studs on there. Huh. I'm going to have to do a bit of research on that guy. Now, what's in this now? Well packaged. He didn't want these things to get dented. That looks like a camera lens in there. Couple of connectors on the back here. Does that connector match up with those connectors? No, it doesn't. Those are all 6-pin connectors, 6-pin. Interesting. Yeah, that looks like some kind of... sorry. Baumer. That is, in fact, a lens. Got adjustable aperture there and focus up here. Made in Japan lens. This lens has a MAC address. Type TXG06C P17. Okay. That doesn't tell me very much. This lens shroud just says type IP tube, 62 millimeters. Okay, I'm going to have to do some research on these things. That lens has me intrigued. This is fairly clearly a camera of some sort. Wonder if I can figure out the pinouts. It's a nice O-ring. Yeah, it's a nice O-ring around that. So this is clearly designed for an outdoor application. Well, those are going to be interesting to dig into a little bit and see just exactly what they are. This is interesting. It seems to have an XYZ coordinate to it for some reason. Wow, obviously fairly industrial and heavy duty. I am intrigued. Thanks, Mark, for sending this stuff along. obviously, anybody who's watched the channel for a while knows that I like tearing down some old electronics just to see what's going on inside it. And that's where these are going too. I mean, there's a long shot that I might be able to get one of these things operating enough to play with it. Maybe enough to make it dangerous. Who knows? Have to stay tuned for a future episode. Well, that was a fun one. Yeah, I'm constantly blown away by the generosity of you guys. I've got some great viewers out there. Thanks for this stuff. But first, we'll just go quickly over the shipping times for the stuff that I ordered from China. These two lights took 93 days to get here. All this was before Corona. So these guys took 93 days. The fuse assortment took 71 days. And the Nunchuck breakout boards took 28 days, which is kind of what things were taking last summer. And I was hoping that things were going to take this summer to start happening, but that ain't going to happen. Anyway, and then these two things took a couple of weeks each to get from various bits of the States to here. And so thanks again to Adam and to Mark for sending that in. As I said, this ST-Link's going to get some use when I get down to playing with those blue pill boards. And these things are going to be teardowns and possible deeper investigations as to what the hell they are as time goes along. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters for helping me buy these things for the mailbags and buying me a beer, too. That's always appreciated. And thanks to all of you for watching all these videos over, the hell has it been, 3+ years? 6,100 and some subscribers. I'm just constantly blown away that that people are actually interested in what I'm up to. So cheers to all of you guys. Thanks as always. Comments and questions down in the comment section. I will talk to you later.